Today we're going to have a quick run through of opening Stitchmastery and creating a very simple lace chart and then exporting the image to use in a pattern layout and also the written instructions. So I have my Stitchmastery software folder open here and I want to open the application file type, which is the Stitchmastery.exe file. Let's double click to run that. And when the software has opened, we can either come to File, New and New Chart Diagram, or we can click on the New Chart Diagram icon. There are various different things that you can edit to suit within the chart diagram setup. We have another video that goes into this in a bit more detail, so I'll put a link in the description box below to direct you to that if you want more details. But I'm quickly going to set this up with a few less rows. We'll call it Tuesday's New Chart. And I want this to be a flat piece of knitting. Click Finish to create the chart. And our blank canvas has been created in the drawing area. Now you'll note we didn't add a chart title, and we can very quickly come into Edit Chart Properties and create the title. As you can see, we already have output text for this chart, so if you were to come and work this chart as it stands, your first and third rows, as in your right side rows, are knit and the wrong side rows are purl, and that's reflected in the written instructions so far. But we can start adding some other stitches to the chart. So let's have a few yarn over. So just click on the stitch you want, come back over the chart and click to place it in the cells that you want. And we'll just pop these. And let's add some knit decreases. So we could have some slip, slip knits. Oops, didn't mean to do that. If you want to correct a stitch, you can just draw over it. That's no problem. So continue with our slip slip knits and let's have some knit two togethers on the alternate rows. So as you'll see, the key has been adding symbols for the new stitches that have been added to the chart as we go along, and our output text has also updated to match. And you'll notice that Stitchmastery has picked up on a few repeated stitches. So for instance, our row 1 begins with knit 2, slip slip knit and yarn over, and then we have the exact same selection of 4 stitches following twice after that. So it's condensed those stitches into one set of bracketed repeat and repeat that 3 times, or work that 3 times, and then finally knit 3. And the same for the row further up. Now, if we want to print the chart or place the chart and key into a pattern layout document, then we will need to come to Diagram and Export to Image. Now, I haven't selected anything on the drawing area, so when I export, it will give me everything that appears here. And I'm happy for that to go in the weekly tip folder. Stitchmastery has a few different image formats that you can choose depending on what you're going to make your pattern layout in. I'll choose PNG at the moment, it's quite a flexible format, and we'll click OK. And then we shall do the same for the written instructions. So come to Diagram and Export to Text. We only have a text format for this, and we will include the stitch glossary as well. It's heading into the same folder. So if I come and open the weekly tip folder, you'll see we have Tuesday's new chart knit 2, which is our working file. So that's the file that we would need to open if we want to come and make changes to this chart or add new charts into the same actual working file. But we also have our PNG file and our text file. So I open the PNG file first of all. My laptop opens this in the Photos app, but depending on your setup, it might be a different program that opens as the default. So I could print this all from here, or I can then paste this into for instance, a Word document or Photoshop, InDesign, whatever other program you might use to set up your pattern layout. And you do also have the option to export your key separately so that you can place it in a different area in your pattern layout. If we open the text on my laptop, it opens in Notepad and it's plain text with no formatting, but I can do anything with this text that you would if it was in a normal text document. So we can remove row spacing, we can add a space below the title of this, and you'll note we have the stitch glossary as well for all of the stitches that are included in the chart. And it's very easy to just then highlight, copy and paste all of the written instructions into your pattern layout, and from there you can format it to suit. So you may want to change the font, add bolds or italics, you may want to increase the font size to make your pattern easier to read for somebody with a visual impairment, or you may set up a separate file with just the written instructions in large font for somebody who needs a low vision document. There's been quite a lot of recent discussion on low vision file formats, and I will link to a blog post by Gemma Thompson, who is a tech editor based fairly locally to our team here in Scotland, and she's been doing some research and giving suggestions as to some things to consider when creating a pattern layout. It's obviously not the case that everybody who knits is able to read size 12 or 14 text and able to process a chart, so it's very useful to have the bare bones that you can edit and format into a setup that will suit more knitters and enable them to knit to your pattern.